We've got quite a good start tonight. I get along with the web guys here. How many of you guys do web? Good. You guys might learn a few new things today. Right, so people, GDG is a pretty important place to be able to talk to people about moving changes such as these. And the web apps is a really awesome up and coming, well, not up and coming, but technology is not a lot of people know about. My name is Francois from Merwe. So I'm a web developer by day and a full stack developer by night. So as you said, I spend a lot of time stroking my beard while staring at code. And I dabbled around with code before I grew a beard. And I know you guys are dying to know the answer, but yes, beard does make you a better developer. I seriously think you guys should try it. Well, at least you're a girl. It's weird, you know, the beard piece. So, I'm quite a lazy developer, and but you know what they say, that a lazy developer is a good developer because you'll usually take the shortest route solving problems and saving you money if you employ them. So that's why I brought a video along because I'm lazy, you know. So I'll show you guys this video. So what is progressive web apps? Now I think Google is definitely the best person to explain this to you. So let's get this video started and see what you guys think.
The only thing that is up. The only thing that evolves faster than technology is our expectations. We want everything. Better, easier, now. Suddenly, downloading an app feels like it takes forever. And in many parts of the world, data is still at a premium, with 1 megabyte costing up to 5% of your monthly wage. Let's face it though, until now, the alternative to native apps hasn't been great. But that was this. Progressive web apps can now deliver mobile web experiences with a native look and feel, offering features like real-time push notifications, adding a site to your home screen so you can easily jump back to it with a single tap, even when you're offline. Plus the ability to make quick payments on the go. And all from your browser. This is the next generation of the mobile web. So what are we waiting for? Let's go and build something great.
Pretty neat. What do you guys think? Google's better than me. Nice videos on top, so. Right, so that's just a quick introduction of what progressive web apps are, and there's a lot of aspects, a lot of components to progressive web apps, but there's one technology that's been leading the way in terms of being able to create offline progressive web applications. Can anybody guess what that is? No. Service workers. The service workers is not a technology that was designed or made by Google, but it's fully supported by Google. And I think one of the first browsers to be able to run service workers was Chrome. And Google is a very big advocate of service workers. And no, it's not app cache, but almost. I don't know how many of you guys know what app cache does,
But it's the same as service workers. It caches the content of the files that you've loaded, but in a very rudimentary, simple way. Service workers does the same thing, but it's very intelligent. It can give you feedback, it can give you errors. It can redirect your website to a different page when you're offline or there's an error. So, the lazy guy, he's coming out again. Another video, guys. Let me show you. I hope it works this time. Let's see.
For too long, users have been left staring at a white screen. For too long, they've been let down by the cruelties of network connectivity. And for too long, we've been powerless to help. We've been left waiting. But no longer. A new browser feature has arrived. A total game changer. A feature that lets you control the network rather than letting the network control you. Who is this new feature? And what promises does it bring? Introducing the service worker.
Pretty cool. Guys, I'm going to drop the mic. Can you guys hear me? So that's just a quick introduction of what service workers are. Service workers is that thing that makes it all possible. Let me explain it in a little bit more depth so you guys can see and understand what service workers really do. So, just on a quick level, service workers are very closely resembled to web workers. And if you know what web workers are, you guys know it? Right, so web workers is a process that runs in the background of your browser. So in Java, you've got one thread. With JavaScript, you've got one thread. If you want to do calculations, you usually block the UI, so you can't move around elements. That's a bit difficult. With web workers, you can start up multiple threads and have simultaneous processes running in this at the same time. Our service workers work in that same concept. But it sits in the background, and it is able to intercept all traffic that goes in or out of your app. Anybody can also start up other processes for you as well. So that's where the power of service workers come in. It's an intermediate, it sits in the middle of all that traffic that goes through from your website to the network. So let me give you guys an example. I'm going to go to Google. So you open your browser, you type in google.co.za.com. So, what will then happen, obviously you will get a translation from the DNS, and you will do a request to that server to get that first initial page, the index HTML page. And that will then be responded back to your browser and then be rendered and displayed to you. So what the service worker does in this instance, service worker first, when you do that first request, it goes and checks up, what's this guy requesting? Oh, he wants the index HTML page. And the service worker will say, do I have it in my cache? Do I store it? And it'll say no. It'll go get it from the network and it'll store it in the cache. Next time you would like to grab that in this HTML page, do that same request, it'll serve that from the cache. But now that's where the service workers go. Because there's different strategies on the website. So that's for the next slide. And the next slide comes. So there are different strategies in caching your website. So what I understand now is that when I request a file, that file gets cached. Or I can say, no, this file will change a lot. I don't want to cache this file. But now you can have these three different strategies. You can say, always leave the one from the network first. So if you do a request, it'll go and it'll see, okay, this guy's requesting this file. Okay, no, I will not send from cache. I will send it from the network.
say cache first, which is always a very bad idea because you want to be content to site. It's going to serve a form of cache all the time. That is very cool. Well, unless you speak before I go, I don't know. Search for cache first. One form of it, so you can have both things. But then the last one, which is fantastic, is called fastness. And that's literally the name. It's not good. So fastness, how it works is that when you request a file, a simultaneous request is sent out to the link and to the cache. And it responds to which one is fastest. So if you work with your cache, you put two different cache. Or if you don't have a cache, you'll get it from the network. And you wouldn't wait for a cache to say, no, I don't have it. No fix to my network. You'll get both or return. Another thing that that request that you send over the network goes unheard, you will update your cache if it falls in your network. Which is pretty amazing for our solution. So this is just an example, a good example of what that code would look like in your service book before, which we'll get to now to explain to you. So just visit there, it adds an event listener to a navigator's object or your browser. It says that if there's a fetch, respond with the following. If that file is not found, respond to the following form. So in that case, you could say, I want any. In this case, not found. It'll show you a 404.png. Right, so, what does Google think as well? So, Google made a bunch of false technologies that goes hand in hand and gets tied up together with the service worker. So, Google got up against this and said, but the service worker, how can we use this to make our product better, to make better products. And that's really the clever. This is the technology stack that I've been using for a demo that I'll show you guys soon. It's called my Firebase and it's Service Worker to tie all these things up. I don't know how many of you guys work with Firebase, but Firebase is a front-end library, a front-end driven library that is made by Google. That is very powerful. At the moment they want version 1.5. Moving to version 2, supporting 8x6, which is really important to get a proper object to front-end code, say that. So, Firebase is also very tightly coupled with material design. If you take a look at the website, take a look at the components of the device, you'll find a link to all the material design pages on the course, because it's not enough. Showing you exactly how you should use this component. Which I don't know, as a developer, I'm pretty good. You may as well be right person. That's very powerful because you can see, this one's actually what you can do. That's a good one, you know. That's quite cool. Next is Firebase. The Firebase is that intermediate storage backing thing that you need. So, we've bought Firebase, I think it's about a year and a half ago. And they've just improved. There's so many functionalities that they've added to this Firebase. And you don't really need a service layer to look at this Firebase. Firebase provides you so many things that real time data. Database that updates as you type, as you add data to this database. It also will send you back a response saying that you subscribe to this data and this data changes. This change here, but you don't have to go back up. I wonder if this guy changes this field input in the feature. The Firebase is real time, so you subscribe to this data to get the thing, that's why you don't have your listen to the database, changing that data. And then service workers, as the last thing, helps a lot with finding all these things together. So, I'll ask you to that. You can see what I can do. Of all the cups. Let's go.
goes. Right. Okay. So, I've already made a folder. It's a DB folder. So, all I'm going to do is a very nice modify tool called the CLI. So, I'm going to try and show you guys. So, it's very easy to use. It's called Polymer in this. And they give you options for what application you want to start. It's just like it. It's quite cool. It gives you a lot of functionality as well. So, now that Polymer in this will create a basic structure for you as a must kickoff for when you should start designing or creating or creating that. And it does a lot for you. It gives you the power to build the project and to even deploy that project. And there's a cool thing as well, a very cool thing is that it gives you service workers out of the box, and which is very awesome. So let me show you guys what it looks like. Creating this all straight from the command. Pretty cool. Basic tool design layout, so nice menu. Show that it's responsive as well. It's pretty cool. It's actually got the user's routine as well, so you can get different buttons. And the very cool thing that I can show you now is that it uses service workers. So I open my developer tools, I can go over to the network, to the offline mode. If you guys have any questions, I think this would be a good forum as well. If you guys have more questions,